Materialization made easy. Today we're going to see how to materialize with confidence directly from your Tinybird dashboard. We use a table of 100 million rows of events data, the same data we use in the Tinybird guides. So what's materialization? Put simply, materializations aggregate and transform data incrementally as new data is appended to a table. So why materialize? Performance, performance, performance. Speed wins. If you get the same results faster and process less data, what's not to like? Previously, Tinybird users materialized from the CLI. Now you can also materialize from the user interface. Let's see how. We have a table of events with 100 million rows. Here you can see the columns. Date, product ID, user ID, type of event, an adjacent object of metadata, including the city and the price. These are the fields we're interested in this example. Our endpoint will be the average purchase price in each city for each day. Let's have a look at our pipe. There are just three nodes. The first node is the filter. Here we set the day, extract the fields we want from the JSON object, and filter for by events. Always filter first. Then we have a node with our aggregation. This is the node we're going to materialize later. Here we calculate the average price. Finally, we have the endpoint with a parameter to give results for just a single day. Now let's duplicate the pipe to show how to materialize. We can change the name. And delete the endpoint. In the UI, a pipe can either produce a materialized view or an endpoint. It can't do both. Now all we need to do to materialize is click on Create Materialized View from this node. And here we can see we have the sorting keys that we need, day and city. We also have the partition and time to live. If we click on the advanced, you can see that behind the scenes, Tinybird has analyzed the query and proposed the engine, the partition, sorting keys, and time to live. With the advanced tab, you have the flexibility to override Tinybird's proposals if you know what you want. Let's go back to the basic view and create materialized view. This will partially populate the view with about 10% of the data. This is a way of validating that everything's working as expected. This looks great, so let's populate with all the data. First, the partially populated view is truncated. Populating takes about 15 seconds for these 100 million rows. Don't worry about the strange looking values of the intermediate states. That's how it works. We'll use the merge modifier in the endpoint to get the latest values. Eventually you'll see the message, from now on, everything you ingest into the origin data source will automatically populate as well. That is, incrementally. Now we can create a new endpoint. Let's do it in our original pipe so we can check that the results are the same. We copy the endpoint. And change to select from our materialized view. Very important, we need to add the merge modifier to get the latest values from the intermediate states. And of course, the group by for day and city. We run, and we can see the results are the same as previously. So everything's working. How about the speed up? Let's see how long the original endpoint took. We run the endpoint and go back to look at the information on our endpoint page. And we can see that the endpoint took 59 milliseconds. Okay, let's try with our materialized view endpoint. We can republish with our new node and now run again. Going back to our observability page, we can now see it takes only 22 milliseconds. This is a very simple node. For more complex queries, the speed up for materializing can be many X. So, to recap, the state modifier is added in the materialization process. Intermediate states look strange, but that's expected. In the endpoint, we use the merge modifier to get the latest values. Now you can materialize with confidence. Tinybird analyzes the query in the node that you want to materialize and proposes a way forward. These defaults should work well, so giving you more robust materializations with fewer errors. Why not sign into your Tinybird account and try it out? Thank you for watching.